Wave, I'm Leo Walden. I'm here with Tyler Jenks. Today, we're going to talk about Bitcoin, specifically where we are, why it's such a critical time period. Tyler did 3 tweets this morning about where we are and why we have actually some reservations about where we are right now. So that's pretty simply what we're going to be talking about. So I'll hand it straight over to Tyler.
Great. Thank you very much, Leah. Before we get into the actual charts, and we're only going to look at three of them today, very detailed of where we are right this very minute relative to everything we've been saying for the last 3 weeks. And then we'll take a look at Hyperwave, and I want to give you a couple of new ways of looking at where we are relative to Hyperwave. But before I do that, I just wanted to take a minute and congratulate you, Leah, on last Saturday taking Tone Vey's course on his random number generator, which is very, very confusing to many, many people. I've studied it for years and years, but the way Tone Vey's uses it and explains it, I was just thrilled that you took the time to take that course. And just wondering what your thoughts are on it.
Thanks, Tyler. Huge shout out to Tone. You were an absolutely amazing teacher. It was really crystal clear and also actually a lot of fun. Honestly, I was actually quite nervous, Tyler. As you very well know, when I was working for some of the top hedge funds on Wall Street, my background was specifically fundamentals. And so knowing just such the huge, vast differences, which in the fundamentals world we kind of call voodoo of technical analysis, I thought it would be absolutely over my head. And then specifically this very mysterious, difficult, that Tone calls random number generator, I didn't know what to expect. But really, he was crystal clear, and I actually feel pretty armed and ready. So, thanks.
Terrific.
Thanks. It was good fun. Thanks, Tyler.
Yeah, that's a great accomplishment. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay, let's go right into the charts. I'm going to do a screen share. We're going to pull up the short-term chart of Bitcoin. And the same 4 lines that I've been using are on this chart. The first one is this descending trend line from the top at 19,666. I'm actually using the close the day before, which is a higher close than the reversal candle that went up to 19,666. And then I'm using the close on the day before this big down candle. To me, this is the final resistance that we have to worry about in terms of getting the prices back to the old highs. We've got a couple of other ones, but we will talk about them as we get closer, if we get closer, and we're all hoping that we do get closer. The second line I have is from the bottom, the 5,920 that we hit 2 weeks ago. And here I'm using the close on the candle before the reversal candle, and then I'm using the close on this down candle, as well as the bottom of the wick, 2 candles over, as the uptrend line. So what we have is we've got the merging of a very long, powerful downtrend line, and we've got the support of this shorter and hopefully decisive bottom line moving up. We have moved well away from those 2 lines. We still need to get up to about 13,000 to hit the top line. We've got a little room to drop down to about 9,800 and still be above this line. I've got 2 other lines which we have talked about for weeks and weeks and weeks, and they still hold tremendous sway over the movement of the price of Bitcoin. The top one, this one, is at 11,100, and the bottom one, parallel, is at 10,100. We spent a lot of time talking in our last vlog about the fact that once we got up to this line 5 days ago, we couldn't close above it. The next day, we closed right on it. The third day, the wick at the bottom touched it, but the close was right on the upper trend line. The next day, we hit both the upper trend line and almost touched the lower trend line. 2 days ago, we didn't make it down to the bottom, which was a good sign, but we couldn't close above the top, which meant more resistance. And then over the last 24 hours, at least beginning with the change in candle last night, we are above that top trend line and trading right now at 11,526. So how do I interpret all of that? We are still in a downtrend from the top. We are in a very short-term, two-week uptrend from the bottom. We have now surpassed both of the two resistance lines at 10.1 and 11.1 that have had me very worried about the ability to penetrate them. I'm a little surprised at how quickly we got through both of them. That's all the good news. What I am now concerned about is that we are using up so much energy to get through these two lines that at any moment we could get a significant reversal back down through the top one at 11.1 and back down to the bottom one at 10.1. By the time we do that, we will be hitting the uptrend line right here, and it must hold, because I believe that Hyperwave suggests that if we can't hold that 10.1 line now, we've got the fairly high probability of dropping all the way back through the 7,500 area and then finally taking out my drop deadline at 6,300. Now, I'm going to go to a larger time frame with this chart to show the entire movement up to the peak, down to the bottom, and the correction we are now in. And I want to throw on one of Wells Wilder Jr.'s favorite technical systems called the stop and reverse point. Notice that in the uptrends we have over here and over here, the stop and reverse points move up in a parabolic fashion underneath the price. In the downtrends, the parabolic stops are above the price until they are penetrated, and then the parabolic stops begin again under the price until they're violated again, and you get another downtrend. We are now, on a daily basis, in this uptrend, but notice what happens. The higher we go, the faster the parabola begins to accelerate to the upside, and the distance between each of the stops increases. What that means is within the next 2 days, this parabola is going to be right at this apex, which is what I just said we don't want to break. So things are looking very good for Bitcoin, but do not believe, do not conclude that we are out of the woods yet. Things are happening very quickly on an hourly, 4-hour daily chart that suggests we should get some sort of a pullback now, at least down between these two lines. And that will occur as early as this afternoon, going into tonight, going into tomorrow. If that does not occur, if we continue up from here, that will increase the possibility that we're going to be able to break out without that pullback. Now, I'm going to switch very quickly to a very long-term chart of Bitcoin, going back to $300, back in 2016, all the way up to the 20,000 top. We've looked at this chart over and over. This is a hyperwave. And what we are debating is, was this penetration reversal, where the price went below my trend line and closed above it, a phase change that will cause the price to go all the way back up above 19,666, which is what we're debating on this short-term time frame. By breaking above this trend line and moving higher, we increase the odds that we are going back to 19,666. And when that occurs, it will be absolutely certain can be using technical analysis, that we are not in a wave 5, 6, and 7 downtrend that will end the movement of Bitcoin until we get below 1,000. That's what we risk right now. If, on the other hand, we're able to get back to these highs in the 300 some odd cases I have studied going back 150 years, there has never been an instance when we have recovered back to that peak that we don't go on to much, much higher levels. So all the marbles are on the table right now in terms of where Bitcoin is, what the next 48 hours does. But as we sit here at this moment, we have exceeded my two very important trend lines, and we are not yet pulling back. Several other systems suggest that we are on the verge of some sort of a correction back to the downside. So we will keep these vlogs coming at least once or twice a day until that resolves itself. And with all of that, thank you very much. And I am going to send it back to Leah.
Thank you, everybody. Until next time.
Thank you very much.